Yeah, Sudha, Dagumali to present a paper. Yes, free papers have 6 minutes, sir. Please don't go over 6 minutes, okay? And what's your number, please? Your AAOS number?
So it's D8582. I don't remember the number.
Okay, please go ahead.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'll be presenting on corneal evaluation in patients with Parkinson's disease on long-term oral amantadine therapy. No financial interest. Parkinson's disease is a chronic progressive neurodegenerative disease resulting from loss of dopaminergic neurons in the substantia nigra. Amantadine used in the treatment of Parkinson's disease has been proposed to be toxic to corneal endothelium. Amantadine is commonly used for Parkinson's disease for its efficacy in treating drug-induced dyskinesia. Several case reports of amantadine-induced corneal edema have been reported. Proposed mechanisms being idiosyncratic hypersensitivity to amantadine and decrease of endothelial cell count. This study was a prospective longitudinal comparative study conducted in Dr. R.P. Center. The study population included Parkinson's disease patients with and without amantadine therapy, and the patients on amantadine were further subdivided into three subgroups based on the dosage of amantadine using 200, 300, and 400 mg of amantadine. The parameters evaluated for Parkinson's disease-related parameters, ophthalmic parameters, and the endothelial cell parameters. Inclusion criteria included Parkinson's disease patients on long-term oral amantadine therapy on more than 1 year. Exclusion criteria included intraocular surgery, laser, contact lens, intraocular pathology, glaucoma. And ethical clearance was obtained and informed consent was taken from all the participants. NeuronJ is an ImageJ plugin to facilitate the tracing and analysis of elongated image structures like neuronal processes. NeuronJ was used in our study to calculate the subbasal nerve fiber density of corneal nerves on images obtained by confocal scanning. These are the pictures showing normal endothelial cell morphology and the picture showing pleomorphism and polymegathism. This is the subbasal nerve fiber tracing using NeuronJ. You can find decreased nerve fiber density in patients on amantadine, Parkinson's patients on amantadine. Coming to the statistical analysis was done. Chi-square test and independent t-test was used for demographic data comparison, and one-way ANOVA was used for endothelial cell parameters. When the endothelial cell parameters were evaluated among groups and subgroups, there was a greater decrease in endothelial cell density in Parkinson's disease patients on amantadine. It was 1.51% over a span of 1 year. And among the subgroups, those on greater dosage of amantadine had greater decrease, as 400 mg patients having 2.03% decrease of endothelial cell count. Similar changes were seen in hexagonality and coefficient of variation, with amantadine patients having greater decrease of hexagonality and greater increase of coefficient of variation, with the subgroup on increased dose of amantadine having a major change. Even subbasal nerve fiber density was found to be decreased more in Parkinson's disease patients on amantadine, with 1.82% on amantadine patients, and those on increased dosage of amantadine had greater decrease of subbasal nerve fiber density. Corneal endothelium plays a pivotal role in the homeostasis of cornea. The normal rate of endothelial cell loss per year is 0.3 to 0.6%. The decrease in our study was 1.51% in amantadine in Parkinson's patients on amantadine, 0.94% in amantadine naive patients, and 0.55% in controls. The decrease in endothelial cell loss was higher in with the dosage of amantadine use, with 1.36% in patients on 200 milligrams, 1.53% in patients on 300 milligrams, and 2.03% in patients of 400 milligrams of usage. No case of corneal edema or decompensation was noted in our study. Subbasal nerve fiber density was less in Parkinson's patients in our study compared to controls, with lesser values with higher doses of amantadine use. The corneal endothelial cell characteristics showed a statistically significant difference, decrease in endothelial cell density in all Parkinson's patients compared to controls. Subbasal nerve fiber density was less in amantadine patients, was less in Parkinson's patients on amantadine compared to amantadine naive patients and controls, which was also statistically significant. We recommend ophthalmic consultation prior to and during amantadine therapy. Careful medication review is essential for patients with unknown etiology of corneal edema. Cautious use of amantadine in patients with low endothelial counts. These were the references. Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor. Are there any questions? We can take one question.
You are told to evaluation, but is there any suggestion in case of amantadine toxicity and cornea in Parkinsonism? Any line of treatment you'd like to advise? Or
sir, we stopped the usage of drug.
Pardon?
We stopped the amantadine and give hyperosmotic agents for to reduce the corneal edema.
Between the groups, were the subjects age matched?
Yes, sir. Age matched, and diabetes and hypertension were excluded.
They were matched. Okay, thanks.
Did you look at differences within the groups? You've looked at differences between the three groups, but have you looked at differences between the groups from baseline to the 12-month values?
Sir, I didn't understand.
No, within the groups, no? Let's say you had three groups, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, sir.
So within group one, the baseline value for a particular parameter and the 12-month value, were there differences between that? You have not examined that in the paper?
I have examined that, sir, but there was not statistically significant difference.
Okay. Thank you, doctor. Thank you. Thank you.